Hello everyone, Chris back again with you in Gaming Zone. Here we go again with Sandstorm coverage, quite similar to what I've done in past with World War 3, if anyone still remembers that at least. Although I'm not interested to play this game anymore, I would like to make one more upload to discuss the current state of the game and also the future for me. First, let's start with the content. Ever since I quit playing, like 3 months ago, the game is doing nothing to retrieve back its lost player base. During this period, only one map was released, with most of the plans by developers postponed for a really long period of time. Lately I was recording some footage for the background of this video, and I have to say, those rounds were fun, before starting being repetitive all over again. Hell, it feels like I'm reusing my old footage, but no, this is new gameplay. Same thing, different day, let's say. Besides the winter map introduction, I have seen nothing new in the game. Where have the new planned weapons vanished? The TBA map? Even the dumpster called Battlefield 5 puts more effort in releasing patches, even if most of them are broken. Here comes in the stagnation factor. I've seen this kind of problem with Battlefield 1, when the DLCs were coming really late during the life cycle, killing more than half of the player base. NVI, although managed to solve some problems related to optimization at most parts, has to focus on some new additions for the game. I understand that indie titles have different route and focus compared to bigger projects, but you can't let the established player base vanish, especially when the game is not that popular. As of recording this video, the player base of Insurgency Sandstorm is about of 1400 people. For comparison, the original Insurgency, released on Source Engine, has the same number. The sequel has the same amount of players, if not less than its prequel. Yeah, the situation is really bad, especially when the new game modes released, when the server is barely populated. I don't want to see this game end up like World War 3, it having at best a server populated in a rush hour. The semi-realistic type of games have their own unique twist, and that's why people still play them. However, these can simply be supported by introducing fixes for already existing problems. The stagnation factor can easily kill off a game, and this is what's currently happening to Sandstorm. I highly doubt that console edition releasing next year will improve the content situation. It will generate money, but there is no crossplay capability involved whatsoever. I don't know what to say, everyone. I've had my own recommendations for the developers with the previous upload. Even my friends have put some effort in suggesting new content. But looks like NVI have something else on their mind, hence I see rare content editions. At best, we can see some hotfixes for critical situations, and that's it. Now that I covered the current situation over the combat area of Sandstorm, it's time to confirm once and for all. I'll be dropping this game in the long run. Many of you know that I was covering mainly Battlefield, especially during the World War 1 trash fire days. Looking closer at this situation, I honestly can say indie titles from now on will receive only a small amount of coverage. Many of these fall from interest in the long run, and we can witness this with Sandstorm. I really enjoyed the glory days of this title, but those are now gone. All it's left is repetitive experience, with rare moments of new content being brought in. I find this situation sad, because it's quite similar to World War 3's fate. Thanks, Insurgency, for the good times, for the funny drunk streams we've had a long time ago, and for trying to replace the rotten franchise entry with something interesting. This is where I'm saying goodbye for this game. It may be temporary, it may be a farewell like World War 3, but the memories will always be there. That's a wrap for today. As always, thank you for watching this upload, even if it was in this kind of style. Don't forget to subscribe and drop a like if you enjoyed, since it really helps the channel growing. This was Chris, see you next time.